Hello everyone, I Akansha Kumari
and I Vishnu Priya,
student of BA final year Department of Home Science, Patna Women's College, are going to present our research topic, a comparative study of nutritional assessment and level of anxiety among working and non-working women during pregnancy. In introduction part, we will discuss about working pregnant women, non-working pregnant women, socioeconomic status, nutritional assessment, and level of anxiety.
Pregnancy is the duration of carrying a developing fetus inside the body, and the woman who carries this child inside her body is called pregnant woman. According to the World Bank data 2018, 22.1% women are serving in different sectors of the society. Those women who are either employed in small-scale industries and organizations or who possesses ownership and authority in organizations in government, private and quasi-government sectors are called working women. Coming to non-working women, these are those women who are not engaged in any type of paid employment.
In this slide, we will discuss about in socioeconomic status of working pregnant women and non-working pregnant women. According to National Center of Educational Statistics 2008, socioeconomic status is an economic and sociological combined total measures of a person's work experiences and of an individual's or family's economic and social position in relation to others. For analyzing a family's socioeconomic status, the household incomes, earners' incomes, earners' occupation, combined income are examined, whereas for an individual's socioeconomic status, only their own attributes are assessed. Socioeconomic status is used to show the economic differences in the society. It is divided into three levels: high income group, middle income group, low income group. Now, we will discuss about nutrients, recommended dietary allowances, and nutritional status. Nutrients are those constituents that are found in foods which must be supplied to the body in suitable amounts. This includes carbohydrates, fats, proteins, minerals, vitamins, and water. Coming to RDA, the dietary allowances of nutrients are recommended on the basis of current knowledge of nutritional requirements of different age, sex groups, different stages of life, and the country's food on dietary habits. It is calculated as recommended dietary allowances. Lastly, talking about nutritional assessment, the British Dietetic Association has defined nutritional assessment as a systematic process of collecting and interpreting in order to make decisions about the nature and causes of nutrition-related health issues that affect an individual. Different methods can be used in assessment of nutritional status, and here we have used the dietary methods to calculate nutritional status. The last topic of our introduction is anxiety. It is defined as emotion characterized by feeling of uneasiness, worried thoughts, and physical changes like increased blood pressure. People with anxiety disorders usually have recurring intrusive thoughts or concerns. They may avoid certain situations out of worry. Further, we will discuss about two levels of anxiety, that is high level of anxiety and low level of anxiety. It is calculated on the basis of mean of marks obtained in the questionnaire.
Problem of the study states that nowadays there are many factors which affect the physiological and psychological health of women during pregnancy. Working pregnant women serve in different sectors of the society as well as take household responsibilities with dedication, which can lead to hectic life schedule, and they may become ignorant to health. Whereas non-working pregnant women is only busy with household chores, which can make her anxious, and may they lack for exposure to facilities and knowledge regarding their purpose of the study says that in today's changing world, there is a need to study how nutritional assessment and level of anxiety differ in working and non-working women during pregnancy.
The objectives of study are first to assess and compare the nutritional status of working and non-working women during pregnancy, and second to assess and compare the level of anxiety in working and non-working women during pregnancy. The hypothesis of study are first, the nutritional status of working pregnant women will be better than the nutritional status of non-working pregnant women, and second, the level of anxiety in working pregnant women will be high than level of anxiety in non-working pregnant women.
The present slide shows the materials and methods that were used in the study. Purposive research design was adopted for the research study. Case study method was adopted as research method. For sampling, convenient sampling method was used, and areas for study was Surji Holi Family Hospital and areas of Delhi Road. Here, it is shown that based on the objectives of the study, total 70 respondents were selected purposively, and out of total 35 working and 35 non-working pregnant women were selected as subsamples. For our research study, a survey schedule was prepared and pilot survey was also done. These pictures show the process of data collection. Now, coming to the results and discussion, our first figure put emphasis on the income groups to which the working pregnant women and the non-working pregnant women belong. It is clear from the slide that 17.14% of working pregnant women belongs to lower middle income group, 65.71% of them belongs to higher middle income group, and 17.14% of them belongs to high income group. Whereas among non-working pregnant women, only 5.71% belongs to low income group, 31.43% belongs to lower middle income group, 17.12% belongs to higher middle income group, and rest 45.71% belongs to high income group. The second figure gives us information about 24-hour recall of diet of working and non-working women during pregnancy. According to the figure, 100% of both working and non-working women consumed cereals, pulses, green vegetables, other vegetables, fruit, and milk or milk products. 97.14% from both the groups consumed dry fruits. Among working pregnant women, 80% of them consumed non-vegetarian diet, while 60% of non-working women were eating non-vegetarian diet. This indicates that in both groups, most of them consumed food from all six food groups. Table 1 contains information regarding nutritional assessment of working and non-working women during pregnancy. It informs that 14.28% of working pregnant women consumed food less than the required RDA, 80% of them consumed diet meeting their RDA, and only 5.71% of them had meals which was more than RDA. On the other hand, in case of non-working pregnant women, 8.57% of them had meals which was less than the RDA, 88.57% of them consumed correct diet meeting their RDA, and only 2.87% of them consumed meal which was more than the RDA. Table 2 depicts the level of anxiety among working pregnant women and non-working pregnant women. This table stressed that 28.57% of working pregnant women experienced low level of anxiety and 71.42% of them had high level of anxiety. While in non-working pregnant women's category, 77.14% had low level of anxiety and only 22.85% of them experienced high level of anxiety.
Now, coming to conclusion part, in this study, efforts were made to find out the nutritional assessment and level of anxiety among working and non-working pregnant women and difference between nutritional status and level of anxiety among them. It is very clear from the study that both the groups have more or less similar socioeconomic status. The major difference was that most of non-working pregnant women belonged to high income group. In the study, it was found that working pregnant women had more knowledge about nutrients and balanced diet. They also preferred qualified dietitians for diet plan and suggestion. But non-working pregnant women believed more in their own choices and seek suggestion from any elderly people of house. In terms of nutritional assessment, it was clearly shown that most of non-working pregnant women took diet meeting RDA. Skipping meals due to fault in time management is the main reason of consuming diet of less RDA among working pregnant women. The study concluded that both categories experienced anxiety, but number of working pregnant women on high level of anxiety was more as compared to number of non-working pregnant women. Some suggestions for working pregnant women and non-working pregnant women are as follows. Working pregnant women must learn the techniques of time management and work simplification. Both the groups should put emphasis on maintaining and enhancing their position in society. Both the groups should help in managing the economical status of society working pregnant women by earning money and non-working pregnant women by saving. Both working and non-working pregnant women should learn about balanced diet and importance of taking meals according to RDA. Meals must be prepared on time so that working women should not skip their meals. Both working and non-working pregnant women should learn and follow adaptive methods of stress management to reduce their anxiety. They must not overthink of any situation.
These are some references for the study. Reference from the book and websites. Thank you.